carry single, medium-sized vehicle, handle, animal, plus 2, speed, drawn, average, overall, DP, overall, HP, 50, hardness, 5, overall, AC, RAM, 3, D6, pace, 5 foot, height, 5 foot, crew, 1, weight, 300 pounds, cost, 100 gold pieces. The driver of a single chariot gains 1/2 cover behind 2 inches of wood, HP 20, hardness 5. A light warhorse can pull the chariot at a speed of 60 feet, even with an unusual heavy driver aboard. Chariot double, large vehicle, handle animal plus 2, speed drawn 4, overall HP 80. Hardness 5, overall AC 4, RAM 4D6, pace 10 foot by 5 foot, height 5 foot, crew 1 plus 1 passenger, weight 600 pounds, cost 400 gold pieces. Occupants of a double chariot gain 1/2 cover behind 2 inches of wood, HP 20, harness 5. 2 light warhorses harnessed abreast can pull the chariot at a speed of 60 feet. By swerving the chariot, the driver can have it follow behind either horse. This choice doesn't count as movement. Mobile redoubt, huge vehicle, handle animal plus 4, speed drawn, clumsy, overall AC 3, section HP 100, hardness 5, section AC 3, RAM 9D6, pace 10 foot by 10 foot, height 10 foot, crew 1 plus 7 soldiers, weight 4 tons, cargo 1,000 pounds, cost 1,500 gold pieces. Essentially, a rolling guard tower. The mobile redoubt is a completely enclosed box of heavy timbers, usually drawn by 4 heavy warhorses. It has arrow slits for firing ranged weapons and heavy doors on each side. The redoubt's weakest point is the dray creatures, so armies using this vehicle usually equip them with the heaviest barding available. Siege tower, large, huge vehicle, handle animal plus 4, speed drawn, clumsy, overall AC 3, section HP 120, hardness 5. Section AC 3, RAM 12.6, base 10 foot by 10 foot, height 30 foot, crew 3 plus 25 soldiers, weight 16 tons, cargo 1 ton, cost 4,000 gold pieces. The large siege tower is a fortress on wheels. Each of its 3 stories features arrow slits and heavy doors cut into foot-thick wood, while the roof has crenellations and a platform with room for a heavy catapult or 2 ballistas or light catapults. A large siege tower's only disadvantage is its massive weight. A team of 10 heavy warhorses or 2 elephants is needed to move it into position. Siege tower, small, huge vehicle, handle animal plus 4, speed drawn, clumsy, overall AC 3, section HP 120, hardness 5, section AC 3, RAM 10.6, pace 10 foot by 10 foot, height 20 foot, crew 1 plus 15 soldiers, weight 8 tons, cost 1,000 gold pieces. Designed more as an enclosed ladder than a proper vehicle, A small siege tower is built to take punishment while it is being pulled up to enemy walls. Invading troops can ascend through the center of the siege tower and reach the top of the wall without coming under enemy fire. The inefficient rollers used to help propel the tower limit the vehicles to a speed of 10 feet, but its movement is unaffected by poor terrain. Land vehicles, the wagon, cart, carriage, stagecoach, sled, war sled, single chariot, double chariot. Then you have the horse, the dog, the warg, drive position, and training point. The zeppelin, the ornithopter, the mobile redoubt, siege tower, triceratops mount. Builders sometimes mount a light catapult or ballista atop a small siege tower. Sled, large vehicle, handle animal plus 2, speed drawn, clumsy. Overall HP 40, hardness 5. Overall AC 4, RAM 3d6, base 15 foot by 5 foot, height 5 foot. Crew 1, weight 300 pounds, cargo 1 ton, cost 20 gold pieces. Drawn across ice or snow, the sled is an almost entirely exposed structure. Driver and any passengers gain 1/4 cover behind 1 inch of wood. HP 10, hardness 5. 8 riding dogs can pull the sled over ice or packed snow at a speed of 40 feet, even if it's fully loaded. Untracked snow slows their speed by 1/2. And deep snow cuts it to 1/4. Stagecoach. Huge vehicle. Handle animal plus 0. Speed drawn. Clumsy. Overall HP 150. Hardness 5. Overall AC 3. RAM 6d6. Base 20 foot by 10 foot. Height 10 foot. Crew 1 plus 7 passengers. Weight 750 pounds. Cargo 1,000 pounds. Cost 800 gold pieces. The stagecoach is a larger version of the carriage. See above. Driver and the passenger riding in front have 1/2 cover behind 1 inch of wood. HP 10, hardness 5. Passengers inside the vehicle have 3/4 cover. Four heavy horses arranged in 2 ranks of 2 can pull the stagecoach at a speed of 50 feet. Wagon, huge vehicle. Handle animal, negative 2. Speed drawn, pull, 4. Overall HP 60, hardness 5. Overall AC 3. RAM 4d6, base 15 foot by 10 foot, height 5 foot. Crew 1, weight 400 pounds, cargo 2 tons, cost 35 gold pieces. A wagon is open top, so the driver and any passengers gain 1/2 cover behind 1 inch of wood. Hit points 10, hardness 5. The most common gray creatures for the wagon are 2 heavy horses, which are strong enough to pull the wagon at a speed of 35 feet, even if it's fully loaded. Wagons are the most common means for an invading army to move siege engines from place to place. The wagon can also be equipped with a heavy catapult, adding 2 tons to the wagon's weight and eliminating the cargo capacity. For a light catapult, adding 1 ton to weight, leaving 1 ton of cargo space for ammunition. Warg war sled. Huge vehicle. Handle animal plus 2. Speed drawn 4. Overall HP 100. Hardness 7. Overall AC 3. RAM 6d6. Base 15 foot by 10 foot. Height 5 foot. Crew 1, plus 3 passengers. Weight 900 pounds, cargo 700 pounds, cost 400 gold pieces. Goblins in snowy climes use their warg allies to pull massive sleds covered with makeshift armor and spikes. The driver and passengers aboard such a war sled gain 3/4 cover behind a 2-inch thick barrier of steel and wood. HP 20, hardness 7. Two wargs abreast pull the sled at a speed of 35 feet. Halfling war wagon. Some people find the idea of halfling war wagons dubious or amusing. Those people have never seen one in action. Halfling war wagons are dangerous and impractical. A war wagon might not be much of a threat to a group of mid-level adventurers, but it's lethal on the battlefield. Use the stagecoach statistics above for war wagons, except that driver and passengers alike gain full cover. The standard war wagon is designed to allow halflings to safely fire ranged weapons on the battlefield and protect their skulkers until they get close enough to strike. However, halflings are clever and resourceful. They often adapt their wagons to suit personal fighting styles or specific circumstances. Siege vehicles. You have the mobile redoubt, small siege towers, large siege towers. And then you have also horse, elephants, the drive position, and the turning point. Siege tower. The war wagon simply has a siege tower mounted on top of it. The wagon is typically 10 feet tall. A siege tower extends its height by another 10 feet through a set of gears and scissor mechanisms. The roof of the tower can pop up another 10 feet to deliver a strike force of skulkers into a parapet. The siege tower war wagon weighs 1,000 pounds and costs 2,000 gold pieces. Special vehicles. Even more types of vehicles are available for specialized needs. Some are strange, rare, or experimental. Others are everyday accessories to getting around. Dwarven tunnelers. Huge vehicle, profession miner, plus 4. Speed burrow, 10 feet, clumsy. Overall, AC 3. Section HP 40/120. Hardness 20/5. Section AC 3. Ram 10d6. Face 10 foot by 20 foot. Height 10 foot. Crew 5 plus 10 soldiers. Weight 20 tons. Cost 70,000 gold pieces. This rank-like vehicle slowly digs tunnels through earth, although stone stymies it. Dwarves occasionally use tunnelers in warfare as well. Their adamantine armor enlarge enough to accommodate a squad of 10 soldiers. The treads have been magically animated to provide propulsion at the direction of the crew, who pull levers while they watch the earth for signs of cave-ins. The massive drill at the front is better than a ramming prow. The tunneler never takes damage from rams it initiates. Forest crawler. Huge vehicle. Handle animals plus 2. Speed 40 feet. 4. Overall HP 100. Hardness 7. Overall AC 3. Ram 3d6. Face 10 foot by 10 foot. Height 15 foot. Crew 1 plus 2 passengers. Weight 900 pounds. Parvo 700 pounds, cost 117,000 gold pieces. Few vehicles are well suited to the elves' forest homes, but the forest crawler can move through the woods by traveling above the undergrowth on its spindly legs, looking somewhat like a massive spider. The forest crawler is used to patrol the forest boundaries and get from place to place when speed is of the essence. It's all legs. Let it ignore most terrain penalties to movement. In a ballista mounted along the vehicle's undercarriage, reloads itself magically. A veil of obscurity. See magical augmentations. Earlier in this chapter, provide camouflage if the forest crawler remains stationary for one full round. Kanto's Lament. Colossal vehicle. Profession sailor. Plus 4. Speed fly. 40 foot. Clumsy. Or wind times 20 feet, nautical average. Overall AC, negative 3. Section HP, 50 hard, 50 hardness 5. Section AC 3, rigging 80 HP, 0 hardness. AC 1, ram 12d6, face 8 foot by 20 foot, height 10 foot, craft 10 foot, crew 20, cargo 150 tons, speed wind times 15 feet, if 75 tons or more, cost 450,000 gold pieces. This magical sailing ship is often used by slavers to move their illicit cargo from one place to place. It has a cloud kill, enabling it to fly at a speed of 40 feet, but it often raises its lesser wind favored sails to gain a speed of 60 feet, or extrapolinear journeys. Planar sails are stowed below decks. The navigator's cabin contains charts of certainty. The ship has two ballistas mounted on rotating platforms that fire 5d6 lightning bolts once per round. The ship is a valuable prize, and the slaver lord who owns it is loath to let anyone know how powerful his ship is. He travels by air only at night and in wilderness areas where Kanto's Lament is unlikely to be seen. But the ship comes to Earth at pre-arranged points to pick up and drop off slaves. Nautilus. Colossus vehicle. Profession. Sailor. Negative 6. Speed 20 feet. Nautical 4. Overall AC negative 3. Section HP 40/80. Hardness 20/5. Section AC 3. Ram 18d6. SA ramming prow. Face 130 foot by 20 foot. Height 20 foot, draft 15 foot, crew 40, cargo 50 tons, cost 250,000 gold pieces. The massive armored vehicle was once a galley, though few sailors would today recognize it. It's been armored with adamantine, made airtight, and outfitted with air bladders stolen from a gnome submersible. It includes a ramming prow and 5 luxury passenger spaces, a huge water elemental bound into service turns the massive screws at the rear of the ship. The vehicle mounts no weapons, relying on its armor and the strength of its crew to survive encounters with aquatic dangers. Though a powerful craft, the Nautilus is difficult for even a trained crew to manage. The creature of the Nautilus, the lore master Rataga, recently lost the vessel to a kraken and its minions. Rataga, who teleported away, believes that some of his crew members may yet survive, and he's willing to hire adventurers to recover the ship. Shadow carriage, huge vehicle, handle animal, plus zero, speed 120 feet, 4, overall HP 90, hardness 5, overall AC 3, RAM 4d6, base 15 foot by 10 foot, height 10 foot, crew 1, plus 5 passengers, weight 400 pounds, cargo 500 pounds, cost 100,000 gold pieces. Darkwood carriage infused with shadow stuff is drawn by 6 phantom steeds. As the spell cast by a 13th level sorcerer, once per week it can cross over to the plane of shadow for up to 13 hours, traversing 42 miles every hour, regardless of terrain on the material plane. Treat as the shadow walk spell cast by a 13th level sorcerer. Special vehicles are shadow carriage, forest crawler, dwarven tunneler, and the Nautilus. Then you have the phantom steed, drive position, and turn.